Hey, what's up you guys, Vusa Designer here, hope you're well. So let's just go over on what we're going to be doing in this video. If you recall, on our previous episode we opened a crypto trading account, we verified that account using KYC, we secured the account using a Google authenticator. So in this video we're going to be depositing funds to that specific account. You can deposit funds using cryptocurrencies, a bank wire transfer, or even a credit card or a debit card. So I'm gonna go ahead and log into that specific account. If you haven't opened an account yet, check out the information popping up on your top right of the screen right now and go ahead and start there. So once you're logged in, it's gonna take you to your dashboard. If you can't find your dashboard, hover over on the avatar icon and click on dashboard. Once you're there, you wanna click on deposit, and you can see that you've got a cash deposit, a crypto deposit, or to buy cryptocurrencies using a credit card or a debit card. Let's click on the cash deposit. Here you want to see if your currency is supported. You can type your currency here. Mine is ZA, which is not supported. So you can see if yours is supported, you can go ahead with this option. But we're going to go back because we want to buy cryptocurrencies using a credit card or a debit card. So I'm going to click on deposits again. And I'm not going to do the crypto deposits. However, I want to buy cryptocurrencies using a credit card or a debit card. So I'm going to click on that. So once you're here, you want to set your currency. Mine is ZA. So I'm going to type ZA. And I'm going to select it, and this is the currency that you're moving from your bank account, and this is the cryptocurrency that you want to buy. So but we don't want to buy Bitcoin or any cryptocurrency right away, because if we do that, that means we're going to be buying it at the market price. And keep watching, because I'm going to show you how to get these currencies obviously at the cheaper price. So in here you want to select what is called a stable coin. So I was supposed to have a stable coin video before this video, however I had some technical difficulties, which means I'm gonna have those episodes coming right after this one. But basically the stable coin that we want to select is BUSD or Tether, which is USDT. Basically a stable coin is just a crypto version of a dollar. So in this case I'm gonna click on Tether, and you can punch in the amount of money that you want to move from your bank account. In my case I want to move, let's say, 18,500, and you can see how much Tether you'll be getting. So which means from my rents I'm moving to a US dollar version of a cryptocurrency, which is Tether. Obviously there are many other cryptocurrencies that are stable coins, but we're gonna cover that in future episodes. So I'm gonna click on continue. In this page you can see that there are fees that are associated with these transactions. So some people find this to be a little bit expensive, but it doesn't really matter. You know, irrespective of what broker or what exchange you're using, you are always going to pay high fees when it comes to onboarding from fiat to crypto. So you want to go ahead. Okay, this order has expired, so I'm going to go ahead and refresh that and just proceed with the payment. An OTP is going to be sent to your phone, so go ahead and launch that and get that OTP so that you can verify this transaction. So I'm going to log into my phone right here and get the OTP. I'm going to click on the notification and get the exact number that I need here. It's 7630, and hit submit. So it's going to start processing. Once it's done processing, then obviously we can see if the transaction was successful or not. Okay, it's successful. Then we're gonna go to our wallet. Over here you can see the overview of your wallet and the current balance, and especially the funds that you just deposited to your account. And you can see we've got, you know, a positive balance of about $1,249, which is obviously USDT. Now you want to hover over to trade and click on advance. Just click on advance. Alright, this is our chart, but first we need to get a ticker symbol so we know exactly what currency we're trading against which currency. This is similar to when you're trading Forex, because you have to trade one currency against one another. In our case, we want to trade, for example, Chainlink. So we need to get a ticker symbol LINK and come back and type it on our platform. So we're looking for LINK USDT. Once we found that, we want to go ahead and select it. So basically now we're trading LINK USDT or USDT LINK. these are currencies that we're trading against one another. But before we go ahead with that, let's just pause for a moment so I can explain to you exactly what is going on here. If you look at the chart, this currency is actually trading around $31, and we're actually anticipating that this price is obviously gonna fall below that. So what we want to do is not to buy this currency at the current price or at the market price. However, we want to set our own ask price. That's why in the beginning of this video I said I'm going to show you guys how to get this currency obviously at a cheaper price. So what we want to do here is to set our own ask price, which is obviously below the asking price, right? So we may set our own ask price to be around $29, you know, $28, $25, $20, even, you know, $16. So when the price falls below those price points, our orders will get triggered, which means we'll no longer be holding USDT. However, we will be holding LINK to our portfolio or in our portfolio. So we want to go ahead and just type the price that is lower than the ask price and obviously put the amount of money that we're willing to spend on that specific trade or on that specific order, then press buy. And once you press buy, you can see the notifications obviously on the bottom right of your screen, and this order is not yet triggered, so you can always, you know, cancel this order at any given time as long as it hasn't fall below the price point. And if it falls below the price point, it will get triggered automatically, which means you don't have to be manually be on the computer or be on your phone looking or waiting for these orders to go through. In the next video, I'm actually going to show you guys how to navigate around this trading platform, because I know if you're just using it for the first time, it can be actually very intimidating. So I'm going to show you exactly where to find all the tools that you need to execute your trade correctly. So if that sounds good to you, make sure you click on this video and watch our next video. Until then, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you there. Goodbye for now. Bye-bye.